Oh. Welcome everybody to the podcast, the Mega64 Podcast. On deck, we got one half of the A-team, Eric.
Yeah.
Just kidding, me, Derek.
Wow.
With a D. And three-fourths of the C-squad. Eric? Mm-hmm. Just kidding, he's D-squad. Garrett.
Oh, thanks.
Sean.
Whatever.
So what was three-fourths, and you? Are you the third fourth?
If you'll let me finish, we have a special announcement. Uh-huh. Eric is being promoted.
Wow.
He is now three-fourths of the C-Squad.
Wow. Congratulations. Who's the fourth in our C-Squad, just so I know who my teammate is?
The fourth is an open enrollment program. Mm-hmm. You get to pick somebody off the street, some lucky young child. You're going to mentor them. And all the things that you're good at in the C squad.
Now, who's in the B squad? If we're the C squad, like who else is there?
Kevin.
No way.
Kevin. By himself. And it's actually officially known as the Bouchong squad.
Whoa. Oh,
yeah.
He didn't show up for work.
He did
for
not.
He's done enough.
Yeah,
what
so
the
he's
fuck?
Still in the B squad. We're in the
Rocco
C squad.
Rocco and Kevin will not be joining us tonight. Sorry to say. So
I'm not sorry.
If you were expecting to see them, go ahead and turn it off right now. They're not going to be showing up. You're stuck with us, baby.
It just dawned on me that, like, back in the day when we had podcasts and people would be gone, someone would inevitably say, straight cast.
They would say that.
You yeah, that times have changed.
Times
though.
Have changed.
Now
I was just thinking about that, and I was like, damn.
Now,
that's a long time ago.
Yeah, there's no such thing as a straight cast anymore. No. That there's a moratorium on straight casts.
Well, it's been scientifically proven we're all in the spectrum, baby.
We are in the spectrum.
Scientifically proven.
Some people are on this side of the spectrum. Some people are on that side
of
the spectrum. You never know.
I don't
Sean
know.
And me, we lean.
Theme song. Are these cups clean?
I don't know. Probably the milk cups. Probably
yeah,
not.
Yeah, Rob would probably
brought
them out
here for milk. I wouldn't. Would you even want to try it?
They look clean.
Yeah?
Well, this is the lean cast, so.
Yeah. We are mixing.
Oh, don't put that with that.
We got liquids.
No.
Ooh.
It's too much.
We're live.
We're leaning. Lean cast.
Oh, my God.
That cup, that red cup.
So, now that I've got my scissor up, let's have a discussion. Welcome, everybody. You're joining us on a hot Sunday night. You are with the Mega64 boys. We're not going to be bogged down by a bunch of jibber-jabber and nonsense.
No, it's called the bullshit night.
Right. So we're not going to grind to any halts just for some bullshit reason.
Why would we?
That doesn't have a point. We're on point tonight. Welcome. We're coming right off our biggest event of the year, Gamedays at Disneyland. Thank you, everybody. If you came out and joined us, thank you. If you didn't come out and you didn't join us, thank you, too. Because it was a perfect event.
Yeah. You would have ruined
it.
It
was like the perfect amount of people.
Yeah, one less person, one more person might have thrown the balance off. We had, it was pure chemistry at Gamedays this year. And I don't use that word lightly. Everybody had sex with each other. Confirmed.
Congratulations.
That's what chemistry means.
Whoa.
No more V's in our club.
Except me. I'm still a V.
Oh, yeah?
You carry that card?
I'm the only person who did not lose it.
That's pretty strong and Christian of you.
Who didn't lose it at game days. I am strong and Christian. I'm glad you bring that up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tangent. Cheers. Side note.
Yeah,
side note.
Yeah,
have you seen the video?
Cheers. Good job.
My sister. Cheers to being Christian.
Cheers to being Christian and strong.
I saw a video today. This has nothing to do with video games, but it's a wonderful video. I encourage everybody to look it up. It's a woman making an argument about how Monster Energy drinks are actually the drink of the devil.
Drink of the devil.
Oh, no.
Have you seen this?
No.
Have you seen this?
The line of... Okay, go ahead. But
I thought she made a great point.
She did.
I'm pretty much convinced Monster Energy drink is a satanic beverage.
Oh, whoa.
And you know what? You drink it, bottoms up.
So what she does, she has a card of Hebrew caricatures, and she's pointing out She's like, look at the monster logo. It's an M made of these three lines, but the line comes up and then comes over and it never connects.
It's true.
So none of these lines are connected. Now look at my little Hebrew chart. And she holds it up and she's like, this is the symbol in Hebrew for six. So literally, the monster logo
the mark
is
of the beast.
666. And then she goes on to say, she's like, look at the O in monster. What's that? A cross. And then she goes into all this other stuff, yeah. which is very interesting.
Sure.
Look it up if you're interested. True. But I'm going to skip to the end where she goes, makes all these arguments, blah, 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 blah. And then she comes back to that cross and she goes, and what is the sign of the devil worshiper, of the Satanist? It's a cross upside down.
Right.
Well, guess what happens when you go bottoms up, baby? You're drinking to the devil.
Guess what happens when you go bottoms up? Well, when it's on the store shelf and being advertised to me,
it's a Christian beverage.
It's a Christian beverage. Yeah, it's in the sign of our Holy Spirit.
But then you turn it upside down. Mm-hmm. That's the thing. If you're Christian, you never go upside down.
Some would say I've joined the cult of Starbucks here. Does anything spectral or kind of spooky happen?
Well, it's red. That's the color of the devil's skin.
Yeah. Why is the devil red?
Why is he red? Red. You know what? Speaking of that, that's a quote from our most recent video, The Game Crypt. Check it out if you haven't seen it. Deleted scene. There was more to that quote, but I cut it down. It was, why is the devil red? Love or hate?
That's the extended version.
I'm pretty sure the devil is red because of love.
Yeah. You know what? Interestingly enough, I found this has nothing to do with video games. Side tangent. I have read that originally in representations of the devil, he was blue.
Yeah, I've read that too. Like Dante's Inferno shit.
Yeah, you've heard of blue devils. Well, yeah. I guess the original mythology was that God is in heaven, you know, and he is a body of like warmth and love. And so there's this feeling of warmth and heat that comes from God. So to be the devil would be the furthest removed from that warmth. Sense. So literally where the devil resides is the coldest
freezing
point.
What if we've had it wrong all these years?
And hell is a freezer.
Hotter than hell by KISS doesn't make any fucking sense then.
Because
it's colder than hell.
When hell freezes over,
Earth is hotter than hell.
Yeah,
it's already happened.
Dude.
It's already happened. Fuck. Hell froze over a long time ago.
Wow.
And you think global warming is a lie. F you.
That's right.
F you. Drink a monster and worship the devil.
That reminds me, did you guys ever get the Minion ending in Twisted Metal where he goes to Hell, Michigan?
No.
Why does he go to Hell, Michigan?
Well, he asks Calypso to grant him a wish to go back to Hell.
So they sent him to Michigan.
Yeah, he didn't specify. That's Calypso. He always gets you. He's a tricker.
That seems totally worth it to beat that game and get that ending.
Fucking Calypso. Do not trust Calypso.
Never, ever, no.
We're talking video games. We're talking Twisted Metal. This is the number one video game podcast on the internet. Let's bring it back to our original discussion. Gamedays was this past weekend. What did you guys think of Gamedays?
You know, it started off the first day, which people saw last week's podcast of the panel, which I thought went really well. I thought it was really cool. The Game Grumps came out. They took time out of their schedule to do that with us. We didn't pay them. They just did it because they're friends of ours.
Shoots out to the Game Grumps.
Shoots out.
They lost their virginity, so they got paid.
Dude, finally.
They got paid.
I know Aaron's been waiting.
Yeah.
You know what? The only bummer to me, honestly, was that podcast went up and the comments were so negative about them. That was like, man, these guys did us a favor, and they just got shit on real bad for that. But
I didn't read the comments.
Shake it off.
So what was the worst comment?
I like T-Swift.
Shake it off.
What was the worst comment?
I don't want to say it because it's real bad.
Why? You should say it real loud and you wrote it.
But they...
Is it racial?
Yeah, it
is
was...
Is it?
It was. Wow. It wasn't racial.
They call them honkies?
No, they didn't do that.
That'd be fucked up, guys.
It was just all fucked up stuff, and it's like, man, these guys just came out and just did us a favor, but whatever. I mean, like... I was always embarrassed because, like, our fans are cooler than this. Like, what's happening? What are they doing? Like,
but the people that comment on YouTube probably aren't the people that came out.
No,
to the
and the
event.
People
probably
at the
just
event
people watching
were stoked they were there and they're super cool. So I'm not talking about those people.
I just always, you know, I don't care what YouTube comments say. Ever since I read the comment, I was looking at that video of Nazi Germany, and this dude left a comment that was like, Hitler was an idiot because he liked Italians and he aligned himself with Italians. And it was a comment on YouTube saying Hitler wasn't racist enough. And it kind of all clicked to me, like, yeah, the comments on YouTube are fucking whack.
Yeah.
I don't think I should put much stock into what these say.
I don't remember the last time I commented on a YouTube video that wasn't, like, mine in response to somebody.
Comment on someone's video if there's no comments on it.
Like, just to go watch a video
and then comment on it.
You seem to want to know what I have to say.
I like to leave comments if I feel like it will elicit a reaction from the person.
Right.
I'm not going to leave a comment, just a voice and opinion.
You know, there are people who comment on things like Instagram, for example, where there's 1,700 comments. Why?
Yikes.
No one's going to see what you said.
Right.
What does it matter?
Oh, I leave comments on those. When McDonald's posted on Facebook, try our new fish nuggets. 6 nuggets made out of fish for $1. I left the comment, fucking gross. And I knew I was just a tear in the ocean of comments, but I still had to leave the comment. Today I left a comment.
That's funny.
Today.
You did this today.
I left a comment on Walmart's Facebook.
Wow. Why do you follow Walmart?
Anybody who follows me on Facebook, they saw I screen capped one of Walmart's comments on their own post. Because Walmart, welcome to the number one video game podcast on the internet. Walmart has an exclusive Call of Duty exoskeleton that can only be only be unlocked by purchasing Doritos and Mountain Dew products at Walmart. So I told them, you've become a walking stereotype. Mm-hmm. You're living the joke. And I was disappointed because Walmart responded to every single critical comment on that post, except for mine.
You got them.
I did get them.
You know,
they posted, this is what I screen capped, it was something like, let us know what you unlocked with your Doritos and Mountain Dew purchases. Yeah, I'm going to get right on that. Yeah. I'm going to clear my schedule out.
I did it, and then I first went on Facebook and talked to Walmart about it.
In other Doritos and Mountain Dew news, Doritos is coming out.
Yeah,
Doritos.
Is that real?
That
Doritos flavored Mountain Dew.
Now here's the thing: people say it's real. People say they tried it. I've seen pictures and all that stuff. But it's just something to go viral, right?
Yeah,
it's just like bullshit.
I don't think it's real.
We will never try that. We will never ever try that.
Well, I'm glad we live in a culture where people are coming up with such brilliant ideas as Doritos, so that they can go viral.
I mean, that's what. People are paying a lot of money to do that now, and like going viral is like what people want to do.
If you
want
to go viral, you should do like a zombie thing.
Yeah, ooh.
Like that hits. What's the best show in America right now?
Take a guess, guys.
Zombies.
Duh.
iZombie.
Yep. Fuck. Coming soon, hopefully, guys. I need it to be viewed. I gotta sell those books.
Watch the show so that Garrett can sell those shitty
comics.
Please,
it needs to have some fucking interest or ratings or the baseline.
They're worthless.
So like I said, no stupid tangents this week.
Right, cut the bullshit week.
Cut the bullshit. Gamedays. Thank you to Game Grumps for coming out. We really appreciate it.
Definitely.
Whether our fans liked you or not.
No, they liked you in person.
Everybody who went to Gamedays had a great time.
Yeah.
I asked every single attendee personally. Not really. But if I did, they would have all said they had a great time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I could tell from the vibes in the room that Game Grumps did well.
I was met with nothing but smiles, man.
I haven't heard anything negative to come out of
and
it.
And you know,
honestly, yeah.
No, I was going to say, we showed a new video that's going to come out tomorrow, actually. And
unless you're watching this on Tuesday, then it came out yesterday.
And you know what I'm talking about. The reaction was very, very positive.
It was.
And I'm going to say now, before you watch it, that was all Rocco.
Yeah.
If you hate it, that's Rocco's fault.
He really talked about that in depth before we showed it at the
Because we saw it for the first time.
No one. Well, yeah, all of us saw it for the first time. He made it very clear, like, if it's shit, blame me.
Like, if you like it, it's my, yeah, whatever.
But there was no way it was going to be shit, so he shouldn't have done that.
No, whatever. Go for it.
It was good.
He is.
I was very happy with it.
A god.
Yeah, he's an editing god.
He is a
guys.
God. Can we just take a moment and talk about how Rocco's a god?
Sure. Yeah. Can we hold hands?
No.
No.
All right.
He's a god.
Okay.
What kind of god?
It's
like a Roman god. He's not just like an all-seeing, all-powerful god.
But he's strong.
He's like a god. You know how Bacchus is the god of wine? We've talked about that many times.
We have.
Many times.
Cheers.
Hail Bacchus with my lean.
Hail Bacchus.
I think in modern times, Bacchus can be known as the god of lean.
Yeah.
And Sizzrup.
Yeah.
I think Rocco is the god of making shit videos fun to watch. And
that's a lot.
I agree.
And I'm not even saying that video was shit, but I've seen.
In general.
Wait till you see it.
That's
his most powerful skill.
Mm-hmm. He can do that. He takes nothing and turns it into something.
Mm-hmm.
So
yes. Rocco editing when it's just him by himself, you will see a video the day before and then the next day that are completely different,
not
but
the
it's
same.
The same.
It's yeah. like a clay that he molds.
It's crazy.
It is.
He's very
it's
good.
Very impressive.
He's a maestro.
Mm-hmm.
And the more exhausted he is and the less sleep he gets, the weirder and funnier the video turns out yeah. to be. So, interesting.
He drinks a lot of Monster
he
energy
does,
drink,
so
too.
Think about that.
Oh, good thing to point out. So who's really responsible if the movie's
the,
that good?
The
think
devil.
About that.
The devil.
Think about
Satan?
That. Who do we think?
The devil.
Hail Bacchus.
Could he be, yeah, could it be Bacchus? I don't know. Could
I'm changing,
Satan?
Changing my answer. Rocco is the god of the devil.
That's good.
Wow!
That's, good.
Yeah. That's fucking Whoa. A cool thing to be. That sounds like a place in Destiny that you'd have to go find, like, you'd have to go fight a monster.
That's
at.
Too clever.
The yeah. god of
oh,
the devil.
It's the god of the devil. Yeah. He's like the last boss.
Are we all gods, or is just Rocco god tier?
I'm C.
Oh, you want to get, like, meta?
I would like to be the god of fuck. Like that Marilyn
Manson song? I'm
sure
Manson
you
would.
You are? Sure.
Oh,
you
oh are. Really?
Oh, wow.
Shouts out, dude.
Wow. I've read literature. I've read literature that says... You know, your whole world, your whole existence really is just perceived, your eyes and your brain. Nobody else really factors into what
True.
You experience.
This is my unique experience of uh-huh. life.
When you break it down in those terms, you can't prove the existence of anything outside of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So then who
mm-hmm.
is the God?
You guys could be Truman Showing me right now or Matrix.
Garrett, maybe you are the god of all fuck, or whatever it is.
Yeah.
And we're just figments of your fuck imagination.
Yeah. Your fuckimation.
That'd be weird.
Your fuckimation.
Wow. I got crazy different personality types for all three of you guys, too.
That's pretty crazy.
That's yeah. what's going on. You ever have a dream, and you meet somebody in the dream that's a fully fleshed out character, and then you wake up, and you think to yourself, like, that's not a real person. That was just something inside of me.
Yeah. Hey.
That was a whole alternate personality.
Oh, yeah.
Where did that come from?
When I was a kid, I used to dream about a girl in a blue dress. The same girl, like, a lot. And I stopped having those dreams at like
you know what
I was like
devil
fifth
with a
grade.
Dress.
I used to have these dreams about this
weird.
Girl too, who was very pretty. Like these reoccurring dreams about this girl, and she was always Whoa. On this other side of town. I must have been like 5 years old, and I remember to have these reoccurring dreams of like being a little kid walking through the city at night,
really?
Looking for this girl because I thought she was so pretty. And like a when you're a little kid, you just think like. Ooh, pretty.
I could just yeah. follow her.
Exactly.
Yeah,
it was
you
that
know
kind
it's
of
a dream.
Yeah. And it was this reoccurring dream of this, like, I can still imagine. She was this brunette
yeah.
woman. She was way older than me because I was really young. And she had her hair, like, up, up.
Mm-hmm.
I also had reoccurring dreams of, like, army men figures, but they were Indian figures with plastic feet.
That's Indian in the cupboard.
But they were 6 feet tall, and there was an orange one, a blue one, a green one, and a yellow one, and I would have reoccurring dreams where I'd just go on adventures with these guys.
They would, would they walk around, like, in Toy Story?
I don't remember. This is
kind of more
20 something years ago.
I had weird dreams that I was always either getting like left in the car.
Oh my god!
By my parents, and then I had to like get out and get away from bad guys.
Uh huh.
Or bad guys came to the house and buried me up to my neck in the front yard.
Ooh, nice! I love talking dreams. One time I had a dream and I had to fight all the bad guys from Mortal Kombat, and it started as a nightmare because it's like. Baraka, Scorpion, Shang Tsung.
Yeah.
It was all these dudes, and Mortal Kombat, you get killed. So in my dream, I'm like, these guys are gonna murder me. And I remember whoever shot me with an arrow, like a bow and arrow. I'll never forget this. The arrow like hits me right in the chest, and I look down and I think, that didn't hurt at all. And instantly it went from a nightmare to
God
like
mode.
You're all fucked.
Oh wow.
As a little kid, I'm like,
whoa.
Did you kill Sonya Blade?
No, she's a good guy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right.
Seen the fucking movie.
All
right. Anyways, no bullshit cast. So
yeah, no tangents. The second day,
yeah.
the day at Disneyland,
yeah, yeah.
I thought was so much fun. We had an insane turnout.
Yeah.
Not about, enough time in that day.
It really was
for all the like hanging out and all the people to see.
Yeah. It was a.
I had to leave a little bit early that day. I bought some shoes specifically for game days, and they were half a size too small.
Oh, is that what you left? I didn't say goodbye to you. That's what happened?
I think you left before I did.
No, I was there.
I didn't see you then. But yeah, my feet
we
were...
We left at like 9.
Yeah.
I left at like 10, I think.
My feet
we
were
drive back.
Killing me. They were brand new shoes, and on the way back to the tram, the heel started breaking off.
What the
God.
Fuck?
And
really?
They were 2 days old and super uncomfortable. I was so fucking pissed off. Truth be told, at the end of game days, it was like my feet hurt, my brand new shoes are breaking.
No.
I just want to be fucking home.
Wow, it sucks.
But I took them back, shots out to the van store. They exchanged them. They're not supposed to do that.
Yeah. But well, did you say, like, hey, what the fuck? These are 2 days old.
I did. And I, you know, I said exactly that. And I said I wore them. I didn't go skating or running. I was just walking around, and I felt like there was something stuck in the heel. And I looked down, the heel's coming off. And this girl was like, that looks like a defective shoe. You want to exchange them? And I was like, yes. She's like, what size? And I was like, yeah.
New size. That's cool.
So, no tangents.
No tangents.
No tangents. Shouts out to Vans.
No, I thought it was really cool. I had not seen the new Thunder Mountain until Gamedays. That was rad.
The new Thunder Mountain is cool.
Very impressed with that.
The biggest thing they changed that I noticed was the volcano when you get to the top of the mountain and all the mine up there. It's a fully fleshed out, like, Disney experience now.
Yeah. Oh,
lights
wow.
and smoke and special effects. And it's the, really
the
cool.
The cave starts, like, falling down you and smoke goes everywhere. It's really cool.
Oh, that's
it was really
that's
neat.
Cool.
And it was really smooth. Everyone said how smooth it was, and they were not lying. It was very smooth.
Yeah. Was it not smooth before?
It was not that smooth. It was, like,
you know what?
Gliding.
People need to shut up about roller coasters being bumpy. It's a freaking roller coaster.
Yeah.
It's a mine cart attached to a rail system that was built to piss you off and shake you around.
To piss you off.
That's what a roller coaster... They're supposed to scare you.
Supposed to make you
they're supposed to make you feel like you're going to fly out at any moment.
True.
So when people ride a roller coaster and they get off, they're like, oh, that was bumpy. Oh my God, go home.
This is the first time I've been on the new Matterhorn carts.
Oh, yeah.
And they were a lot nicer.
They were not nicer.
Well, I don't have a boner poking me in the back.
Yeah.
I hate it.
Yeah. I think that's a big improvement is, like, you get your own seat now, so it's not less bumpy. I don't think the track has changed at all, but you're cushioned and you can hold on better.
And yeah, you're not... I never will forget seeing, like, that poor, like, 13-year-old guy who was in between his mom's legs. Like, you don't want to be there.
Yeah, no. Mom goes in between my legs.
You don't want to be there.
That's great.
That's not a fun ride experience.
But that's a great ride to take a girl on, so well, there goes that.
You still got that dark part where you're climbing up and nobody can see anything that happens.
Yeah, just reach out, just do a...
And do what?
Just a secret handshake.
Yeah.
Secret handshake.
Maybe she could do it. Or reach over. It depends on who's in front, who's behind.
Uh-huh. Eric, it depends.
Dude. Yeah.
Use your fucking brain, man.
All right. It all depends. So,
No, but I thought, has Rocco released that castle picture yet? Has that been...
I don't know.
It.
I've been waiting.
I haven't seen it.
I got that picture. We'll put it up this week.
Yeah,
definitely.
I want to see it. Do you have a number?
I counted, I want to say 240. People.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Really?
In the picture, but I know for a fact the picture did not have everybody who was at attendance.
It was so fucking big.
We filled as many people as we could, but I could see groups off to the side, and I could see groups who waited around.
Gave up. They're like, I don't want to fucking stand here.
Also,
I don't blame
the way it was situated. People were in the picture; they weren't seen. Like,
yeah,
I was with people. I was with people that because it kind of took a while, and they were getting like smashed because they were trying to lay down and it was...
Well, it was 240 people posing for a picture, so...
Yeah.
When you think about it like that, it was awesome and it took no time
at all. I also know a ton of people who were like, oh, I missed the picture, or we got a little... They're a little late, so they took off after we went there. So, you know, whatever. It was still an awesome, awesome turnout. It was a ton of fun. It was crazy going to, like, Space Mountain and the line was 30 minutes, and by the time our whole group was in there, it was now 90 minutes. Like,
damn.
We had that much of impact on Disneyland's wait times.
I didn't go on Space Mountain.
What'd you
do? It was Ghost Galaxy.
Yeah, that's stupid.
Hey, Disneyland, take out Ghost Galaxy.
It was like Dead Space. People described it to me as being...
No. Not at all.
No.
Who described it like that?
I don't know. Someone at Gamedays.
Give me a name.
I don't know. I don't remember.
Give me
a name.
If you described Space Mountain as Dead Space...
They're watching right now. You know they are because they went to Gamedays.
What? Are you kidding me?
Hey, I just smiled and said, yeah, man.
I'm trying to think in any way how Dead Space and Space Mountain Ghost Galaxies overlaps. In even the smallest way... They're both in space.
Yeah, that would be it.
They're both in space.
Dead Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy.
Doesn't a flame face chase you around?
Yeah.
No.
He
shows up, like, at the beginning, and then he, like, turns into stars. I remember in the past, like, a flaming ghost hand would chase you.
Yeah.
But I didn't even see that this time.
I saw it.
Master Hand.
I saw it.
Master Hand.
Yeah, it was.
You saw him?
Yeah, I seen it.
It was also when we went to Disneyland for Gamedays, there were multiple days.
Oh yeah.
Special events. It was Harry Potter Day at Disneyland.
Boom. Shouts out to the
Thumbs
Muggles.
Down. No thanks.
And 40s pinup day.
Which
Disneyland.
Did you see that?
Moderate.
Yes.
Moderate thumbs pin-ups. In the middle.
Yeah. I saw some girls who were wearing like one piece old fashioned bathing suits and had their hair put up, and I saw a lot of dudes wearing zoot suits with fedoras. And it's like
out of shape dudes.
Yeah, and like that's not a pinup, sir.
No. I don't know. Why are dudes dressing up for that?
I would think, too, if you were a dude going to pinup
day. You're not a pinup.
Mm-hmm. You're not a pinup. So, I would think, like, I would be a soldier. Somebody who was really into pinups in the 40s.
Oh, yeah,
I would be, like, a greaser mechanic or a photographer.
Mauricio was taking care of that. Mauricio was the photographer.
Mm. Oh, sick. Good job, Mauricio.
Oh, yeah.
I spilled a little.
Shoots out to Mauricio.
I hardly got to see him at Game
Day. I saw him one time.
He was like a villain mysteriously like hiding in the wings.
I saw him one time.
He was in and out.
My favorite person to ride a ride with was Nick Brewer, who had never been.
Oh, yeah, his first Disney trip.
Yeah, he'd never been to Disneyland. And then we were on Pirates of the Caribbean. He liked it, whatever. But then at the end where you go up and Johnny Depp is right there going like, so skullduggery, whatever.
Yeah.
Nick is sitting to my left, which is like right to
closer
the side of the
Johnny.
And as we go up, Nick just sees the gold pieces or whatever laying at his feet. And he starts like reaching over like he's going to take them.
No.
And it's like, don't do that.
He told me that too. No. I saw Nick afterwards. He's like, I like Pirates of the Caribbean. I tried to steal a gold piece. And I was like, you know they'll kick you out for doing that. And he went, yeah, that's what Eric said. I have a friend who rode the, I believe it was Alice in Wonderland ride about 10, maybe even longer, 15 maybe years ago when we were in high school. Yeah. And at one point he was able to reach over and like pluck a flower out from the ride.
Uh-oh.
And he said the moment he got off the ride, security was waiting for him.
Sir.
They took the flower, escorted him out of the park. Goodbye. That was it.
Oh, fuck.
Wow.
Booted out. So it does happen.
Goodbye.
And they keep an eye out for that. It seemed like there were... Oh, we finally got to see some Disneyland gangs.
Oh, yeah. I saw two Disneyland gangs.
I didn't see a gang.
Yeah, I saw two.
I only saw one.
What? Leather... Gang. Oh man! God damn it! I thought that they were there for pinup day because they look like
fucking
They look like
I saw a gang member who was actually there for Harry Potter Day.
Really?
Because he had the Deathly Hallows patch on his biker jacket.
So I saw people. Oh. I saw a couple guys hanging out together. They had leather vests, like big leather vests.
Yeah.
Heavy, real leather vests that said Main Street Elite on the front, and then on the back it said Main Street Elite and has like Mickey Mouse on it or whatever, and then it says Social Club on the bottom.
Yeah.
Because they're fucking Social Club. Wake up, idiot.
Yeah. No, I get it. I know.
Vice did an article about Disney gangs.
Really?
So you can see some more photos there. I also saw...
How do they get in with those vests? I thought they were banning them.
They're badass Social Club members, Garrett.
So they sneak
them in.
I used to sneak my bullet belt in. That's
Hell
true.
They, yeah.
I also saw someone in a denim vest.
Oh. The Hitchers.
The Hitchhikers.
Oh, that's the
and it's
Haunted
Mansion.
Mansion. Yeah.
Mm. See, what I'm wondering, if Main Street has a gang, how does any other gang
get
into the park?
Yep. That's a good question.
I've seen the Warriors.
Yeah. I thought the same thing.
You can't just let somebody stroll through your territory, because then it's not your territory.
I saw the Main Street Elite over by Golden Corral. Did they have to bop their way through Frontierland down to Main Street?
Probably. Yeah.
Did they light a Molotov cocktail and throw it to cause a distraction?
I should have brought three glass bottles. Main Street Elite, come out to play.
Yeah. You know what? Actually,
awesome.
You look exactly like that guy.
Yeah.
You should be that guy for Halloween every year until you die.
That's the guy who gets held upside down. It's the guy who gets held upside down in Commando.
Yeah.
And Schwarzenegger goes, remember when I said I'd kill you last? Yeah, you said.
I lied.
And he lets him go. That's the same
until
guy.
You die.
That is.
Commando's awesome.
That is what a rat man looks like, and I model myself very much after that. It's a mix of that rat man and Todd from Boogie Nights.
What do you do if you're a Disneyland gang? What in the Main Street crew, where we said they were?
Not have sex. That's what you do.
Okay, sure.
Not have a job because you're Disneyland every
what
day.
What do you do at Disneyland? Okay, I'm the Main Street. I'm here.
You hang out.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go get
you hang out with
cone.
Your friends. Yeah, you go get a fucking
dude. You work the streets,
mm-hmm.
You put the feet to the pavement, you're on every corner, keeping an eye out.
Alright.
Making sure justice is being served.
I heard a rumor about the Tomorrowland gang.
Mm-hmm.
Do they have a name?
I don't know.
No, I don't think so.
The Tomorrowland gang?
I don't know them.
I heard that they give back to the community, like, you know, the Yakuza does that.
Uh-huh.
They have, like, cell phone chargers on them, so if you go out,
that's
so
nice of them.
They grant
access. Because it's the future.
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, they're into tech and stuff. Mm-hmm.
I want to go up to a guy at Disneyland with a biker jacket on and ask if I could charge my cell phone out of his pocket.
No, that's what
that's
I read.
That's what I want to do.
That's what I read on that that advice article. So next time you guys are at Disney, just go ask the Tomorrowland gang members.
I want to go with the Main Street Elite to an actual biker gang like bar.
No,
and just go and go, hey guys, we're all in a gang, right?
Oh, yeah. You want to witness an extinction.
Yeah. I told you we have a bicycle gang like in San Diego that does like the same thing.
Yeah.
Where they
yeah.
wear like big leather jackets and with their big patches on
the back. You remember Mike from the Bertos?
Yeah.
He thought that they all hated him and were going to like beat him up.
I don't think they beat up anyone.
No, they're not. They're a bicycle gang.
They go get ramen in Little Italy.
A bicycle gang?
Hell yeah.
On trikes with stereos.
Welcome to it.
Oh.
So
Gamedays is great.
Yeah.
No bullshit.
Gamedays was really fun.
It was.
Yeah.
And
$96 to get in. It was $96.
It was.
Yep.
At Disneyland?
Yep.
Did you use our discounted link?
I didn't.
Well, that's where you fucked up.
See?
You gotta use happened. That link next year.
Should
next
use
year.
The link.
Next year, check the link, get a discounted ticket.
And that wasn't for the park hopper?
Full. Nope.
Jesus.
We will be going again next year. Internet Soldiers gang. We're gonna take over the whole park.
Whoa.
That should be our shirt.
Yep. Next year we'll do.
It should have patches on it.
Yeah, maybe. That's not a bad idea.
And then every time we see a gang, we'll all surround them and go, "You're a long way from home."
We'll outnumber the shit.
We will outnumber them for sure that day.
If you read Mouse Tales, it's funny because in the 80s, the 70s and 80s, they had an actual problem with actual gangs actually fighting and actually killing each other.
Yeah, wow. Jesus.
So, like, in light of all that, this idea of a new generation of gangs with cell phone chargers is pretty funny.
It also says social club, and it just strikes me as guys who really like Sons of Anarchy. But, like, they're like, I'll be in a social club.
Ew.
You like that show?
Yeah, show sucks, dude.
I've seen it. Oh.
That guy that would go do that is just gross.
Oh, that guy.
I've only seen... I saw the first three seasons. I thought it was okay.
That's a lot of seasons.
Well, I really like Seinfeld, and that's why I'm just a cool guy who's really funny.
I'm in a biker gang.
It happens.
I'm sorry, a social club. I wear rings and have tattoos.
I also grew up... I really like Caroline in the City, and that's why I draw such good drawings.
Was her friend gay or not?
He was in love with her.
Yeah.
The guy?
Yeah. But he was also gay.
Oh.
Conflicted.
Oh.
Interesting.
I actually don't remember. That's a good question, because I know who you're talking about, but I was too young to even perceive any of that.
But I remember it.
Hmm.
Did
you watch Mad About
very
You?
Thoughtful.
No.
I did watch Mad About You.
Mad About You was
I hated
was
that
bad.
Show.
I watched that show. Yeah, it was my favorite.
I liked Wings.
I liked Wings.
Oh, yeah. I was a Wings fan.
The Airport.
I was a Wingsman.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think that was USA.
I like Frasier a lot.
Yeah, USA played it like reruns in the morning.
Yeah.
So Gamedays was great.
It was a great Gamedays.
I think that about wraps up our Gamedays discussion, unless there's anything you guys would like to add.
Hope everyone comes out again next year. I want to make that first day even bigger and better. It went for like 5 or 6 hours.
Yeah, it was...
It did. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Getting back to Game Grumps, this was an experimental year for us. This was our 5th year doing Game Days, but we'd never invited another group to come and join us in our adventure. So we recently partnered up with Game Grumps to do Table Flip and some crossover videos. And kind of coming off those meetings and that established friendship was right around the time when we were beginning the preparations for Game Days. So we invited them to come along. Yeah. And
they love Disneyland too. So
they love Disneyland.
Yeah.
But it was an experiment. And like I said, I think it went really well. I feel like the people who were there, they did enjoy Game Grumps and their presentation.
Yeah, I was stoked. I saw a lot of people with Game Grumps t-shirts on that came into our panel and stuff.
It was cool. So next year, I definitely think we're going to try to get some more groups to come and join us. Expand the event, make it a little bit bigger and better. Hopefully it just keeps on growing in perpetuity, which means forever.
Damn.
So you just got
a, it was really cool just to see everyone. Like, you know, we see about conventions a lot, but we were seeing everyone at one place. You know, like, just Jake or Stevie B or, you know, people like all over the world. Royce. It was really cool to see everyone. Yeah. It was really neat.
But there was, like, not enough time to
get
to
everyone.
That was the thing.
There's
not.
There's I said, like, three things to Royce and that was it. I was just too busy.
I really like going there, too, because it's kind of nostalgic. Like, that's where I went to college. So going back to that area and everything is always really fun to me.
When you were in college?
Because I only go once a year.
Did you party hardy when you were in college?
Yeah. It's still kind of carried over, brother.
Oh, hell yeah.
Too sweet me. That was almost it.
Cool. So, that is that. And we have officially run out of topics to talk about.
Well, oh, we're podcast. Out. Anyone play any games?
Yeah.
What have you been playing, Garrett?
I have been playing The Evil Within. Started up again. I took a big, long chunk of my gameplay and I set it aside for the week before game days and then all throughout this week and getting back into my schedule now. Tonight was the first night I sat down and actually played something on a console. And still having a great time. I'm 8 hours in and I'm only in chapter 5.
Jesus.
Oh my god.
I know. But still playing it, still having fun. I need to get back into Final Fantasy 14 when I'm done. new expansions and stuff have been coming out, so.
That's good. Sean, you play anything? Dang.
I haven't.
Nothing?
I haven't. You know what was funny, and this only happened at Game Days, I had people going up to me trying to compare Tiny Towers with me. Like, I was like, oh, I can actually.
Oh, nice.
I have something to talk about here. Cool. Oh, yeah, I have a lot of floors. That was very impressive to people.
100, right?
Oh, more. Please.
Oh! Gary, you look like a goddamn fool.
I am.
But no, it was, I've been playing nothing, honestly. Tiny Tower Vegas, and that isn't even playing. That's just bullshit. So, no, I really want to start playing anything, and I'm dying to play something, but
did
I just
did you get
too
Hyrule
busy
Warriors,
right
or did you just
I did.
Do it?
I did. No, no, I have it. So, I will get back into
I
that
I got
probably.
That Bayonetta, too. I haven't opened it
yeah,
yet.
You haven't even played it yet.
I know, it's pissing me
Come
off.
Come on, man. What about you, Derek?
Nope.
Nothing?
No,
we
took a break from
very busy
game and break. Yeah,
yeah. Actually, I did play a little bit more Shadows of Mordor, but yeah, I've been focusing on other interests this week.
Well, it's important nice. To have varied interests.
It is. I don't want to just play video games nonstop because then I'll turn into a psychopath.
A meme.
Yeah. It's true.
Yeah.
Oh, which is worse.
I actually just started reading a new book. Been a couple years since I did that, but I picked up Blood Meridian by Cormac McCarthy. And it's really good.
What's
I'm
about?
Only two chapters in.
Oh.
But it's awesome so far. It's written in a very strange way. It's kind of hard to make your way through it. Almost like stream of conscious. But what I think it's about, from what I gather, is about a young kid in the like old west who heads out west and becomes an Indian scalp hunter.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Jeez.
That's what I think it's about. I'll let you know how it turns out.
Blood Meridian. Hmm. I've heard the name and the author, but... yeah.
He wrote The Road, and he wrote No Country for Old Men.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Eric, how about you? Any games?
Just Destiny, and...
yeah, we did some Destiny.
Yeah, me and Garrett played a strike earlier. If That's anyone cool. wants to play on PS4, hell yeah.
Who did we destroy the Awakened Archon Knight on
yes,
the moon?
Yeah, yeah, we talked a lot of shit. Me and Garrett were shit talkers.
Oh, yeah.
Time.
We got in the party with another guy. We just made sure he was ready... for us talking shit.
Because we were shit talking up and down.
Was he ready?
Well, we show up to talk shit
yeah.
when we play. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He was not ready.
No.
But that being said, we did defeat the Winter's Kell in the Shadow Bones of the Moon or whatever. Everything,
probably Venus, I think.
Everything about that game is silly, but it's my favorite shooting gallery. It's just like, I have a revolver. Here come a bunch of enemies. Bang, 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 bang. Reload. Bang, 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 bang.
The
bang.
Guns are super fun.
It's a blast.
They made a really big effort in making them, like, sound fun.
Yep.
They're fun to shoot.
Sound fun.
I have a good time. I can do it.
Dude, I love it.
It's a fun game if you play with other people. If you play alone, it's kind of boring. But if you play with other people, it's a good time. So I've liked that a lot.
For the first time in almost maybe over a year, I went to the movies. I hadn't been in the theater since I saw Gravity, and I saw Interstellar today.
Whoa!
So how crowded was it? You only like space movies, basically.
Only space movies.
Yeah.
It was packed.
Yeah.
It was a
full
theater.
Hard to get into.
Apparently, that was number two this weekend.
What?
Big Hero 6 came out as well.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Disney.
But it still made like 50 million.
I want to see that too.
I have no interest in that.
But Ouija was number one last week, and it made 11 million.
Oh shit!
Waluigi.
Waluigi made $11 million. Waluigi is a millionaire.
I just
self-made millionaire. Waluigi.
So I just picture the character like making that amount of money.
I haven't seen Interstellar yet, but did you like it?
I really liked it, but I feel like
don't spoil it.
I'm not gonna spoil
Do
anything.
Do not spoil
I,
it.
I promise you don't spoil anything.
I liked it too.
But you know when you see a movie, I'm not gonna compare it to well, I guess I will, but like 2001, you gotta kinda digest it and it's a lot to take in, you gotta think about a lot of things. I'm still thinking about things. I haven't figured them all out yet. And I was reading some forums about it. And everyone's like, oh, yeah, it's real straightforward. You get it. You just get it. And I'm like, oh, I I don't get it yet. Like, there's a lot of things that don't make sense.
Does that worry you as a father that you won't be able to explain it to your children?
I don't know. It worries me as an individual that maybe I'm stupid, which, mm-hmm. you know, is a fear that...
Does that worry you as a father?
Yeah, sure. Oh,
so
you pass those genetics down.
Right.
Well, no. Maybe Jenny's very smart. And
maybe your daughters won't understand
Interstellar.
Is it dominant, her gene?
If you're not smart, how would you know if Jenny was smart? How would you even know?
Because I know what's smarter than me. Because I'm smart enough to realize that I am not as intelligent as you are. You know?
Does someone did tease you once when you were a kid and tell you... that you might be retarded, right? And then you kind of
This
is my favorite idea that I want to shoot. I want to make this a video.
Was my thinking as a little kid.
This is great.
As a little kid, I thought, what if I'm retarded? Because you would never tell a retarded person that they're retarded. terminology
political correctness aside.
That's what my little kid brain thought when I was like, so forgive me for saying that word. I'm just saying this is what I thought as a kid.
But you
thought because nobody ever said there was anything wrong with you, you're like, well, maybe there's something wrong with
me. And no one was just telling me.
I just thought no one would ever tell.
But you didn't struggle with like reading or anything.
No, I did. I wasn't great at that.
Why would you think that nobody would ever tell somebody if they were like...
I just thought that would be mean to do. So
Mom
you wouldn't
would be polite
do,
and
so,
say...
So that person would go through their whole life thinking they were totally normal because nobody would ever say anything to them?
Yeah, I don't know.
No, it's funny.
I just thought you would never tell a person who is mentally challenged, hey... Yeah. You're not smart. You're mentally challenged. I wouldn't do that.
Sean
so
was waiting.
He was waiting
for a guy to come up, get right in his face, and be like, "You're retarded."
No, but wait.
When he would know that he wasn't.
I've had an idea to shoot this video for like.
It would be a good sketch.
God, like 8 years.
Yeah. Well, that happened.
I have it like all
once
right now.
Once you got like standardized tests and stuff, in later schooling, did you realize like, on average.
I was never great at tests. Like, I mean.
Yeah.
I was okay, but like I was never like, oh, Sean's really smart in this
one. Well, the whole chat is agreeing with you. Holy shit, what if I'm retarded? What if I'm retarded?
Yeah, they don't know.
You know what I think the problem is?
Uh-huh.
That condition was never properly defined for you.
I agree.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Yeah.
I mean,
because you're sitting there being like, man, I did bad on this test and nobody's saying anything about it.
Well, I mean, I will never forget. I was awful at spelling, which I still obviously am. Like, if you read my setup
he's a meme of that. Yeah.
Shouts out.
My site updates are pretty bad. I say tittles a lot.
but for different reasons.
But, you know, so, like, I remember being in, like, fourth grade, and everyone had the fourth grade spelling book, and I had the second grade spelling book. And it's like,
whoa. Oh!
You know,
you got a complex on it. Okay, I can understand that giving Makes you sense. A complex.
Yeah, it did. Yep, and, like, I still...
That messed with me, too.
You feel like you're still at the second grade.
Not like
it's
everybody
kind of like
says.
A fear that I have.
Everyone
like,
else is on the fourth grade book. You're still in the second grade book.
Yeah, and now that like it's kind of therapeutic just talking about it, I guess. But it's like
therapy cast.
If someone implies that I'm dumb, I get so mad so quick because it's like they caught on. They know.
They know
that I had that second grade book.
The defense mechanism kicks in.
Yeah.
Well, this is a safe place. I'm glad.
Thank you.
Who do you think's? Can you order us dumbest to smartest in the room?
I think everyone's intelligent in different ways. So I don't think so. No.
Different ways.
That's no, surprising. I think Derek can recall anything.
That's not true.
Well, wait, no. Like you can retell a story really well. I think like you're really good at that.
Mm-hmm.
Garrett, as we know, can make anything. And Eric is fucking quirky, and he can do these weird things
quirky.
That
you've got a genius level of quirky.
No, like you do things, Eric, that it's just like no one else in the world would do that, but Eric Bedore. It's a weird thing to do, but it makes sense in your world, and
you
I enjoy that.
Fucking quirk.
The dog in
you're like that
Honey,
thing
I
from Deep Space Nine that nobody trusts.
Was named Quark.
Quark. Sean fucking loved that.
You went different. I went Honey I Shrunk the Kids. You went Deep Space Nine.
Yep. Right.
I'm still trying to figure out, Sean. When did you realize though that you do have the normal intelligence? Like when you rented your first apartment and like had moved out and it was
here's
like,
the burn. It never happened.
Yeah. You're still you're
never,
still
that feeling never came.
He's absolutely right.
When
it never
gonna,
came.
But when are you gonna?
He's still waiting for somebody to tell him he's.
When
retarded.
Are you gonna listen? But hey, wait.
Every day he wakes.
So. When are you going to listen to your friends here tell you that you are of normal intelligence?
I believe
well,
that.
Well, he's already graduated high school and attended college.
To be fair, my wife, who I legitimately believe she's very, very
smart.
Yeah,
none of us have what?
She tells me, she's like, I couldn't.
He's the genius.
I wouldn't have married a person. I wouldn't have married you
he's
if you like weren't smart. You're smart.
Yeah.
So.
That's not my thing. Hot and Dumb as a Rock.
What's that movie with Giovanni Ribisi and
the other sister?
Yeah.
Oh, the other sister. Yeah.
What if it's a situation like that? The two of you love marching bands. I love them.
What if Jenny doesn't know?
Yeah. What if she's the? What if you married the other sister?
You guys. You want me to come over and make sure that the oven's off tonight?
I have the inverse problem. I do think I'm smart, and people are constantly calling me stupid.
Oh. That'll give you a complex, too.
No, it just makes me think I'm smarter.
Oh.
You're too...
Like, I purposely...
They're too dumb to recognize.
Yo, you're too dumb to recognize what a smart dude looks like.
I didn't take SATs on purpose, because I was like, I can't
really?
Me neither.
Like, if... Hey, on Howard Stern, I take the IQ test a lot, and they reveal the results. I would never do that.
Okay, so we need to take an IQ test.
No, it's a loose situation for us.
I don't think the SATs reflect
how smart
you
not
are.
Not at
they
all.
Don't, they don't. But IQ test, that's its job.
Right,
but
which is what we're going to do.
Now, if I fuck it up, though.
Yeah, I'm going to get like a 70, and it's going to be a real big problem for me.
If I'm good, then it's like,
Sean, you're looking at it the wrong way.
Uh-huh.
You're gonna get like a high number, and this complex is gone.
Whoa!
You're
that's true.
You're gonna nail it. You're gonna be like, I thought I was down here. I'm way up here.
I'm so smart.
Dude, just think if you like outscored Rocco.
That'd be the greatest day of my life. That would be the greatest day of my life.
Yeah.
Because I would have a new favorite thing to talk about.
Forever. Forever.
How would he deny it? How would he brush it off?
He would talk about how it was like some category, like, oh yeah, he would make some mumbled comment about, oh yeah, well, they asked how many rings are in the Olympics fucking logo.
Sean, how many rings are in the Olympics logo?
I was gonna say six. I was gonna guess eight.
Yeah, I would have been at like four. Sean, you're there, man.
Yeah, I'm there. I also have a constant reminder on my phone.
Oh, yeah. Shouts out.
Oh, cheat sheet.
Yeah. All right. That's why you scored higher than
Rocket. His wife got him that. They are a team.
Kesha's a genius.
Yeah, did you not know?
Oh, that's true. It's on her Wikipedia, right?
Yeah. Well, she said it. So.
She said it, and Ryan Reed believed it until it does. So,
he's a doctor. So who's the genius?
We're not gonna make fun of Ryan Reed this podcast.
No.
You've been mean to him lately. You've been saying
No. Ryan's cool.
Mean stuff.
No, I'm sure.
Did you guys make up for it at Gamedays?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Cool.
Anyways.
So Eric and I saw Nightcrawler.
Garrett saw it too.
I really want to see that.
And we're not gonna spoil Nightcrawler.
No, not gonna spoil anything. If you don't want to hear anything about Nightcrawler, you wanna mute this for a second.
But I will say I liked it, but. Mm-hmm. I try to go out of my way always to not hear anything about a movie. Mm. I want to hear if people like it, and that's it. If you like it, cool.
Mm-hmm.
Even doing that, I still somehow had Nightcrawler overhyped for me. Because when I watched it and it was all said and done, I felt like I was expecting more.
Mm-hmm.
Which is funny because I really knew nothing about the movie going in. So I've had this debate about what I expected versus what I got, but ultimately, I liked it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I liked it too. I laughed my ass off at how funny the interaction with the guy who sold you your ticket was.
Yeah, the guy who sold me... Should I repeat what he said?
Yeah.
I didn't think it was a spoiler, but you got pissed off.
It's not a spoiler, but as the employee of the movie theater who sells you your ticket... You should be in no way discussing the fucking movie.
Here's the debate.
What happened?
Here's the debate. I'll tell you exactly what happened. Chat, you decide for yourself. Did he go too far?
Okay.
I knew nothing about Nightcrawler. I knew Jake Gyllenhaal was in it, and it was supposedly good.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I buy my ticket, and he goes, oh, man, enjoy Nightcrawler. Jake Gyllenhaal plays a really good, creepy guy. That was the end.
Okay, he shouldn't have said that. I don't think it's too far.
That's not too
but
far.
I don't want to hear that from anyone who I'm buying a movie.
But I wanted to shame him so he would notice that I shouldn't say
Yeah, Garrett put him on blast.
You did?
I just went, are you kidding me?
Yeah, Garrett.
You said that to him?
Garrett like walked by behind me and we're like, oh, well, you should never... Never say something like that.
Oh, Garrett.
Man.
And the guy's like, hey, Garrett, oh. Maybe you were like.
I was like, oh, really? That was the guy. He's like, oh, really? And you're like, yeah, discussing the movie right before we're about to walk into it.
I don't want to know anything.
Hey, I can totally see it from both sides.
Yeah.
I can totally understand how you didn't want to hear that. I wouldn't want to hear it either. But.
People are saying the trailer kind of sets that up. I didn't see the trailer.
Yeah, I knew that.
I knew nothing about the
movie. I haven't
seen
it yet, but I knew that.
Mm-hmm. We've been doing a great job of going into these movies without seeing the
real
trailer.
Real cold, yeah.
I haven't seen, for the last three things I've went to, I didn't know a thing about it, and I came out really happy.
The older I get, more I go to the movies, I really enjoy not watching trailers.
Mm-hmm.
I think trailers are kind of getting to a point where they're irrelevant. Not really.
Oh, no. I think that they're cut so differently from what the movie is, you're getting a totally different experience.
But is that good? When you go into a movie expecting something different from what you get? Or, like, what can a trailer... How could a trailer ever benefit your movie viewing experience?
I don't know that it can.
Exactly.
Yeah. What's always
better is not being surprised.
Yeah.
I want to know who's in it and who made it.
Right.
Yep.
But I can get that from a tweet.
Yeah.
Hey, this movie... Hey, P.T. Anderson's new movie came out. Morgan Freeman's in it. It's good. Check it out.
But
that's all I need to
hear. But you know what? We are... Not to say that we're better than the average viewer.
Oh, we're movie snobs.
We are, to the extent of... I'm in the theater now.
Oh, old.
Today, the trailer for Fast and Furious 7 comes on. It's over, and I hear guys going, oh, it's fucking sick. I can't wait. It's like, man, they care. They want to see this movie.
But even if I want to see Fast and Furious 7, if I know it's coming out, I'll go see it.
But those guys, they don't know who Paul Thomas Anderson is. They don't, I mean, they don't know. They know it. That's not for them.
They've moved from, or they're trying to, I think, to move from, like, big trailers. I think the big trailer will always cast the widest net, so it'll always be used.
Like the Marvel movie trailer.
Yeah. But Fast and Furious 7 started putting little snippets on Instagram, like little 15-second, like, short, super short action-y trailers or whatever, or like sneak peeks.
Oh, okay.
And I think that's going to be the way you're going to see a lot of marketing.
They're targeting a younger...
I mean, I think it's already started.
That's targeting a younger audience who's very social.
But I don't think... Because my mom doesn't know about these movies, the trailer is for her and people like that.
Well, yeah, obviously it's to get people aware that this movie's coming out. Right. But if you enjoy movies like we do, where you're kind of in the know about
you like the
what's
directors,
going on.
You follow actors, you follow directors.
Yeah, exactly. Then you don't need trailers. You don't.
The movie poster is what gets the advertisement across. Yeah. Back in the old days, you would just know, okay, Woody Allen's making something new. Here's the movie poster. Right. Oh, that looks interesting. Okay,
and
I'll
it's funny, too, because movies are kind of the only thing where that applies. Like, if a new album was coming out, I can listen to a demo track. It's not going to ruin the album for me.
Yeah. Right.
But if I get the wrong piece of information out of a trailer, it could ruin the movie.
Well, because the movie is a storytelling device, maybe not necessarily an album doing the same thing. An album's a piece of music.
That that's true. I guess if you were advertising a book and you're like, the main character... He might die on page 80. It's like, shut up.
And everything I saw was like a trailer for a sequel.
Yeah.
And it was everything, characters in slow motion turning around. The Hobbit did that.
Yep.
Marvel did that.
Oh, I saw the trailer for American Sniper, which comes out on Christmas.
Yeah. I've seen that a couple times now.
Great Christmas movie. Yeah. I don't think Jesus would approve of any movie more than a guy going to the Middle East and shooting people.
America's Deadliest Sniper.
Shooting kids.
Yeah. I don't know what this is.
Well, I just...
Bradley Cooper.
Clint Eastwood's new movie.
You know, I just...
It looks suspenseful as fuck.
I'm constantly reminded of how much Jesus hated the Middle East.
Mm-hmm.
So he would love a movie where the world's deadliest sniper goes there and just annihilates people.
104 confirmed kills. Yep. They use that stat in the marketing for the film. 104 confirmed.
Go check it out on Christmas with Mom and Dad.
I probably will see that movie. Mm-hmm. And I actually don't care that it's coming out on Christmas, but I do think that's funny.
It is funny.
Oh, yeah.
I liked Gran Torino a lot, so I'll go see this.
Yep.
I like Clint Eastwood's directing.
I don't think I really like Nightcrawler that much.
Oh, okay.
No?
No. I don't. I thought it was interesting and small, and I was fine with that, but it just didn't... It didn't grab me the way that I wanted to be grabbed from a movie like that. I was ready for him to, like, go... For everything to, like, go farther and, like, really take a hold, and I didn't feel like it did that. I love the way it was shot.
Yeah.
It was Paul Thomas Anderson's old director of photography.
Oh, okay.
And Derek was saying, like, there are shots in that that, like...
Yeah, I didn't know that, but when I was watching the movie, it reminded me a lot of Boogie Nights, and then Eric told me, he's like, well, that's the guy who filmed Boogie Nights.
Dude,
it
was shot like that.
It was,
wow.
Yep.
That makes
there are a lot of
sense.
Scenes like that.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool, and I don't say, like, oh, I don't like it, don't go see it. I think... Other people will like it. It just wasn't a movie that I really gravitated towards.
I think people will like it, but don't get it overhyped.
Mm-hmm.
Don't.
Okay, I won't.
There you go.
I won't.
Go in there thinking, like, this thing's gonna drag in the middle and take a dump at one point.
There you go.
And then you might...
Don't even listen to us talking right now.
Yeah.
This should be on mute.
Hey, put your fucking sleeping mask back on and go to bed.
Yeah, it's time for
fucking
sleep.
Fucking bed, baby.
If you want to watch Nightcrawler, go sleep somewhere.
Anyways,
Interstellar, fuck I'm not gonna again spoil anything. I am at the point now where apparently I start crying in movies.
Oh yeah.
Oh no.
Not like tears and tears. Dude. I just have
I know
one.
Why this
one
though.
I just have the one always it's and it's over. Like it is. It's like what am I
we
doing?
We have kids now.
I know, it is.
That's a big part
wow,
of it.
Wow, thanks for spoiling it, Garrett.
Sean has kids.
Yeah, surprise.
That's pretty
kids.
Cool, man.
Sean has
great.
Kids.
Cool.
Yeah, cool. I wonder how it works into a movie where he cried.
Oh no, it's not like.
Oh, thanks, Garrett. Don't try to dig yourself out of the hole. You're just digging it deeper.
Sew it shut. Sew it shut and throw away the needle.
It's true. We shouldn't even be talking about it.
I'm just saying, I was never that person, and now I am. It's really.
But I think that makes you more
again,
emotional.
It's just one. It's just one. Always, and it's just like, man, there it is again. You can't stop it.
I think it makes you.
I teared up during the Ken Jennings Civil War documentary.
Yeah.
Well, but that was a bunch of tough old men going off to die.
Hell yeah.
They knew they were going to.
They knew.
But sometimes all you can do is die.
Mm-hmm. what more is there? You give your life to God and country.
Yeah, so that's pretty beautiful. I guess discovering black holes is equally moving.
Sean was on the news.
I was on the news.
How did that feel?
Did they drop the charges?
I'm good, thank you.
Oh, okay.
I was on the news because I filmed a guy pushing a porta potty with his car.
Uh-huh.
And so I was on the news for that.
So that was on the news.
The closest I've ever come to crying during a movie.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Titanic.
Uh-huh.
When the two old people get in bed together.
Oh, and they, yeah.
And all the water rushes all over them.
Oh.
It's like, oh, dude, hugging to death.
You didn't like
that? You know what?
Have you seen My Dog Skip?
No.
Did you cry when Son... Who died in Lost?
Are you gonna spoil it right now?
Yeah, well, fucking sorry if you didn't watch Lost.
It did end 4 years ago.
Yeah, when, doesn't...
Here comes
spoiler alert for Lost!
Doesn't the water come rushing in on Sun and Jin together?
Yeah, who cares?
You didn't like them? You didn't cry? I cried during that.
I felt... See, here's the thing.
When the water comes rushing in.
I felt bad for their kid.
Here's the thing. In a movie, when I'm watching a movie, it needs to sneak up on me, and then I think like, whoa. Good job.
The old people.
When Sun and Jin, that thing, I saw that coming like a mile away. I was like, I see what you're trying to fucking do here.
She gonna get
it's pinned. Not gonna work.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
My Dog Skip made me cry.
What's My Dog Skip?
It's about a Jack Russell Terrier.
A Jack Russell Terrier.
You know
his
what?
Kid's dog Skip.
Is this like Marley and Me stuff?
They're...
Every movie with a dog,
spoiler.
The dog dies.
Spoiler.
And it's always sad.
Wait. That's what Marley and Me is?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Whoa.
They're making
straight
a
up.
They're making a series out of that.
Why would people like that?
Straight up.
They're making.
I
yeah,
don't
they
know.
Are making a television series out of it.
Why would people? What? Well, you already. Everyone knows that happens, though. They saw the movie.
Uh-huh. Did you? Do
well,
you see,
zombie shows are really big right now.
Have you seen that billboard that someone tagged a billboard for Marley and Me when it came out, and it said the dog dies on it?
That's fucked up. That's great.
That's really funny.
Hey, I've been seeing a lot of. We talked about Doritos and Mountain Dew earlier, but the new Call of Duty is out.
Yeah,
a lot of people.
Kevin Spacey.
They're screen capping an image of like press Y to grieve.
Oh yeah, hold X to pay respects.
Yeah, yeah.
So what?
There's a scene in the first person or in the single player storyline where you have to like attend a funeral and like interact with the grieving process.
Yep.
It's interesting. And a lot of people think it's funny and are reposting
it's awful.
It.
Yeah, that's fucking stupid.
That's dumb as hell. Mm-hmm.
That was a game I wanted to try because I haven't played one since the first.
It looks
good
and it looks fast as shit.
Yeah, it looks arcadey, which I was into.
I remember
I didn't get it.
Playing Fallout 3 and it's like press X to pick this lock and then it brings up this lock picking mechanism,
mm-hmm.
which is tough, but if you can crack it, there's a lot of like cool loot
right.
behind the door.
Uh-huh.
Press X to grieve. What do you get from that?
You pay your
cry. I think you do, like, if this is a coffin, I think you do this.
That's grieving. All right.
I'm just saying.
Now
you
know. Yeah,
when you press X.
Yeah, I've never seen the GIF of it. I've just seen the still image. I know nothing of grieving.
You do know nothing.
It's kind of, like, boggling to the mind, because this whole series is about killing as many people as possible.
Right.
So what's this arbitrary, like...
Right, but this is a white American that died.
Maybe we can make, like, the player, like, feel some remorse, you know, be a little bit ethical in this game. Press the X button, touch the coffin. All right, so do you want the M5 or the AK-47 or the nuke?
They killed your friend. Can you believe that? What? This is a moment... For introspection.
Hold on, there's some people in an airport over
that
here.
Moment is yeah, over. Really? Let's go kill those motherfuckers.
Yeah, kill them.
Fucking wasted. Blah, blah, blah. Done.
I've just seen the trailers for that, and I feel like they paid Kevin Spacey a shitload of money to be Underwood, Frank Underwood,
yeah,
from House of Cards.
Pretty much.
It
looks just like that.
Exactly the same character. He talks the same way. So they did it.
Yeah, I read this thing, and I don't know how like founded this is. Maybe it's not completely factual, but it was talking about like, have you ever heard of, you know, you're familiar with ISIS, of course, this terrorist group.
ISIL? Sure. Or
yeah.
ISIS?
Whatever you want to call them.
Okay.
And
I'm on track.
They recruit a lot of local people to come fight for them, but they also get like Westerners and white people from all around the world to come join their cause. And I was reading this thing that a lot of these people cite Call of Duty. Like, when they join up with these fucking terrorists, they say stupid shit like, yeah, dude, better than Call of Duty. And I just think, like, why do we have Call of Duty? Why? I mean, I never thought about it before. Why? I'm just posing the question.
You're posing a dangerous question.
Just
want to
put it out there.
Hey,
I don't have the
podcast
answer.
Question of the week. Why do we have Call of Duty?
That's a dangerous question.
Why do we have Call of Duty? Is it that fun?
Why are we let there be Call of Duty?
I think it is fun, and it lets you, when you're playing like an online multiplayer shooter like that, I think it lets out some of that old energy, that like warrior energy, like I'm killing these. I can do that simulated in like,
maybe
whether it's Call of Duty or Halo or, you know, whatever.
I guess you can make the argument like maybe these guys would become terrorists even if they played Mario.
I mean, there were the three girls from Colorado that flew to Germany and got detained and sent back.
I mean,
they were going to be
what fucking?
They
idiots.
Were apparently going to be brides for a couple, like for a few
some
guys
ISIL and, guys.
Yeah.
Cool.
Well,
did they play Call of Duty?
Yeah, that's the question. Did they play Call of Duty?
It's a hell of a question.
Yeah, why do we have it, guys?
Yeah.
Podcast question of the week.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. Well,
did you see the Grand Theft Auto V stuff?
Yeah.
No.
You can go into first person and like play the game in first person.
That's cool.
If those controls are like well done, because I haven't had it the controller in my hand yet, that could make that game like hard to get
is
away
that
from.
DLC?
No, it's for the new console releases. And PC release supposedly in like January, I think.
What a smart way to sell those fucking...
Yeah, because not people are going to buy it, for sure.
If I didn't have a PS4 and I had a pretty decent computer, I would probably hold out and get the PC version.
Because
the mod community is going to be insane.
Yeah.
It's going to be fucking crazy on PC. I'm really excited for PS4.
It's going to be great on
PS4, looks good
though.
As shit. It looks great, and it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun, but the PC version is probably going to be nuts.
Multiplayer now in a first-person mode, that makes
it's gonna be a blast.
A total different
It's
going to
be so much fun.
Yeah.
The driving looks hard as fuck.
Yeah.
I can't drive that way.
You could swap,
but,
though.
Yeah,
back and forth,
yeah,
right?
But then the shooting and everything looks like...
Oof, that's cool.
Oh, so fucking cool. I can't wait for that game. I don't want to have to buy it again, but guess what I'm doing?
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, totally I don't want to buy it again. I never even beat it originally.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I had a really good time with the story. I had a really good time.
The story was good, but I don't play those games for the story. I just like exploring the world.
Yep. There's a lot to explore.
That game for me was like, the funnest part is just driving around. Just hauling ass through the Hollywood Hills.
Oh, I love finding the little gang fights and you're just like, oh, I'll kill 15 guys. This is fun.
Oh, shit.
Yep.
Murder.
As hell.
Do we need that? You killing guys?
Yes. There you have it.
We need We need Eric killing guys because he needs to let that aggression out.
What the fuck?
You do gotta let it out.
Well, thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Are we done?
Are we done?
We
come to the end.
Yeah, what time is it?
It's been an hour.
That's pretty good.
Oh, we got another hour to go.
Yeah, we have all this P.O. Box stuff.
We timed it perfect.
We opened an after show.
Oh. Well.
What was that?
Derek.
Wet water.
It was kind of like
a wet
water sound.
It's a wet willy.
Guys, thank you
it's more like dry water.
I mean, if you want to do this, we can do the P.O. Box stuff now on the podcast if you want to.
We can do it on the after show.
Don't care.
It's up to you guys.
Ain't going
to
be no after show.
Oh, shit. Well, let's do it now then. That's fine. I just won't. That's the part.
Okay, all right, let's do the P.O. Box.
Okay, cool.
We got a ton of stuff, so I'll bring it on over.
All right, Sean's playing Sandy Claus.
We're going to do a P.O. Box.
Speaking of Sandy Claus, did anyone go on Haunted Mansion Nightmare version?
Went on twice.
You did?
No,
because the line was too long for me to look at Jack Skellington's
I went with a bunch of people both times, and it was fine because it was just different groups. So it was like, oh, this is fine. I'll hang out and go with you guys this time. I don't mind.
Hmm.
It was fun.
I rode Star Tours, Space Mountain, the Matterhorn, and Big Thunder. And that was it.
Look at that one.
That was it for the whole day.
Wow. Who's that one to?
This is to all of us, I think.
Just to everyone?
Yeah.
Get a knife?
Yeah. I rode on Matterhorn with everyone.
There's an envelope down there?
Then we went into Star Tours, I think. And then after Star Tours, I broke off with a little group and did Pirates.
Yep.
And then, fuck man. have a hard time remembering what I wrote on.
I did.
Ooh, that looks nice.
The day was kind of a blur.
I want to. Can I open this one?
Yeah, sure.
This is from Meg Lavelle, who's a friend that I follow on Twitter and Tumblr. She's really cool. And
Meg, you've got pretty stickers.
Look at these stickers that she put on. Garrett, did you see this?
You did a hell of a decoration job.
Yeah, and it's cats. There's a squirrel, a girl holding little ducks, some John Cena stickers, and some One Direction guys.
All right, let's look inside.
And inside?
Whoa.
Oh. I got a message about this.
She drew all of us.
Yeah.
Hey, Mega64, I hope you like the drawings. P.S. Rocco, my 13-year-old sister thinks you are the cutest. She told me not to tell you.
Oh, Rocco.
So she drew all of us.
This is a great opportunity to talk about how when you're 13, you don't know anything. Oh, you're an idiot.
I want to keep these.
Yeah, keep
okay.
them.
Okay. She drew Stardust and Goldust.
Oh, that's great. Oh,
cool.
Nice. That is, she does, this is what, I follow her because she does like a lot of wrestling fan art, really cool. And then she did stuff. One that's to Eric, and it's Cesaro, and he looks like Sagat.
Oh, that is cool.
Yep, we should do that. This is fucking rad.
What'd you get, Garrett? What did we get?
We got,
that's so great.
We got some fucking, I haven't had this in forever, but apparently Surge
we got some
soda.
Oh, no shit!
Is this, did they
I got a
message. They brought it back.
Yeah, they brought it back. This you can only get, it was sold out in 6 minutes, apparently.
The return of Surge.
I forget his name. Well, he said, he messed me on Twitter, but what is his name?
It's Jim.
I think he overnighted it.
It's Jim Bills? Jim
B. Jim.
Jim B.
Jim.
Jim, thank you.
They're all sealed. Eric,
oh.
The aggressively helpful Badur.
Oh, wow. I'm aggressively helpful.
Here's Garrett,
this
Ace
is great.
Hunter.
These are great. I'm aggressively helpful.
You are. Rocco, Brody, Bodie.
Nice. Just
Brody.
Throw it in the trash.
Shake it
cares.
Up.
Sean, Chip Grip Chapter.
Oh,
sorry.
Classic.
Oh, wow.
Classic.
And Derek Chuckles Acosta. I like that
Higa
name.
Chuckles.
Dude, I haven't had Surge.
You want the knife there. Should we have a Surge? I mean, it's.
I don't know. We can crack one open and try it. I don't want to waste all of our Surges.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
I mean, I got to get some sleep tonight.
Yeah,
you're
it's
right,
true.
You're right.
You know what I mean?
Open?
I don't want to.
We have a
dude,
one.
This is
maybe.
So, like, all right, I'm just going to
here, I can crack open my Surge.
Hey, I got a. This is to me.
Mm-hmm.
A sports jerseys.
Oh, fuck.
I don't know the name. I don't know the name. But it looks like it was expensive.
Wow.
ID recorded. Okay.
This is like a legit jersey.
This thing came all the way from Australia.
What's with the recent flood of P.O. Box gear?
What
we
the
just
fuck?
Talking about it more
is
locally.
It a Jets throwback
the
jersey?
The
Winnipeg Jets.
Whoa.
That's awesome.
Winnipeg, Manitoba, my favorite place in
Manitoba.
This is like
the real deal jersey,
that's
though.
That's an expensive item.
This is.
That's fucking cool. Put it on.
Hey, I don't have a hockey team. I do now. The Winnipeg Jets are legitimately my hockey team.
I actually do like the Jets.
This is from... Who sent this?
You open that, Eric? Oh, sure.
You wanna give it a shot?
Yeah, let's have a Surge.
It's not very good.
Thanks, Jim. Well,
okay,
it's warm.
I don't know who sent this. I'm not seeing a name on it.
Okay. Oh. It might have gotten covered up by...
Oh, this, it's by Nick.
Oh, okay.
Nick from Australia sent us this package with a note, and it says,
Australia.
I'm going to do this in my best Australian
dude,
accent.
Australia! Yeah.
Oi! Dude, the Mega64 Biscuit Boys. It's Biscuit Boys. The real...
Dude.
Australia. Hold on, let me get Australia. Australia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Australia.
Yeah. Just think Foster's.
The real Tim Tam technology. None of that original flavor basic shit.
Whoa.
Nick.
Whoa, Nick.
Whoa!
What?
Whoa. Rocco's gonna be pissed.
Rocco is gonna be pissed.
Rocco's not here.
Yep.
We're gonna make sure he never sees any of these.
We have
raspberry white chocolate.
Oh!
Whoa.
Am I cracking these open?
Chocolate brownie Tim
Tams. Why not?
Am I?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah? All right.
We got
chocolate brownie Tim Tams. Double coat. Literally, it just says double
it's
coat.
Covered in more.
Double coat Tim Tams. I wanna try the white chocolate raspberry.
This is fucking good.
I'll try one.
Oh my god!
This is probably the best Tim Tam I've ever eaten.
Is this the white one? We'll save one for him. There's one in there for him.
Oh wow.
This is like...
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Red velvet.
Right?
Mmm. This is like having sex with a candy god.
Mmm.
Yeah. I put on fancy underwear today.
That's... I'm the god of candy.
Oh wow.
Mm-hmm.
I shaved my legs through this Tim Tam.
Mmm.
And we also have... Double chocolate vanilla Tim Tam.
Oh!
Nick, you're the shit. Thank you.
Are we opening?
I got one.
Chalk brownie.
I'm good now. Personally, if you want to, you can. But
Derek, your call. You can say no. Let's wait.
No, let's wait. But I promise you, Rocket will not get any.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alexandra W sent us, I believe, some tea from Adiago Tea.
Yeah.
Nice. It's called Tea Demons.
To any Mega64 Tea Demons.
This nice.
Is cool little gremlin art that's on there.
What's the inside?
Whoa! It's an assortment. I've never seen this.
Happy Halloween and happy game days. Hope you guys enjoy your new flavor. Keep up the great work.
Disneyland pimps. These are actually like stickers on the thing. Disneyland pimps.
It's on a tin.
Wow. The new flavor. Yeah. Well, I think we can each take a flavor home.
Yeah.
Here you go.
This is neat.
We'll get save one for Rocco because we know my dad loves tea.
I look great, and Rocco looks like Rocco looks like a Lord of the Rings orc got got mixed up with a nerd.
You're happy with your...
You know what? Honestly, Rocco looks like if me and Rocco were combined.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
Look at that. look at that.
Dude, it's mocha nut mate. Thai.
Ooh.
Thai chai and vanilla oolong.
Ooh.
Whoa. All right. Ooh, I got a letter here.
Okay. Dude, this is awesome. You guys are so generous. I'm sorry, Garrett.
You need a knife? Anyway?
Battle Bora... I'm trying to see where this is
I can't get over this jersey. I wish I had his name. He messaged me on Twitter about it, but I didn't know it was like an actual...
I guess this is from D-Glan?
Declan.
Declan. The postage is a picture of Harvey Milk.
That's neat.
Okay.
Which makes me wonder, why is Harvey Milk always smiling so much?
Yeah.
Show
happy
me.
Guy. Happy guy. Happy
show
guy.
Me, like, the goth moment of Harvey Milk when he, like, you know, is doing, like, the crazy goth stuff. I would just like to see the candid goth moments.
I don't think everyone has those moments. I think that's a unique moment.
I think everyone has those moments. Everyone has a moment where they look in the mirror and they put their head down like this and they hold up two finger guns to their head and they go, and they literally, this is what they all say, they go, I'm feeling so fucking crazy right now. I know Harvey Milk had that. Yeah, that was a deleted scene from the movie.
You're probably
Hey, that Tim Tams box, where did that go?
To my left. Which one?
No.
Garrett just...
Because I think I looked at it's right there. The postage on that.
Yeah, it's Australia.
It was like $40 to
$44
ship.
$44 to ship that.
Well, then we should eat more of them.
We will.
All right.
Holy shit. Yeah, let's put all the goodies out.
Yeah, Garrett, which one do we want to open? Do we want to open Choco Brownie, or do we want to open White Vanilla Fudge?
I think White Vanilla Fudge.
Let's do it. Crack it open.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Sure. How's this here?
Dear Mega64, I was making stickers inspired by Botan Rice Candy stickers and made a few for the podcast crew. Sean, Garrett, Derek, Rocco, and Eric. Hope you like them. Deacon.
Declan.
I get those rice candies sometimes.
That's you.
That's me. I think that's Sean.
That is Sean.
Yeah, that's me.
What else we got?
I'm on a picture of Jenny.
I've seen these.
Those are like
I'm holding pizza.
Those are like a nice little dog.
Garrett, you're like a furry.
Yeah, oh, I love it.
Oh, there's me running away from sushi.
Another one of Eric running away from sushi. And is this Rocco?
Yes, it is.
I have fangs and a radio.
Yeah,
Rocco's a furry as well.
Yep, we're all furries.
We're all furries.
I got
dude. That's cool. You look like Arthur.
You see these? I can't see them.
They can't see them.
Thank you, Declan.
Thank you, Declan.
These are great.
This is awesome.
I'm really happy. I have sharp teeth.
Yeah.
I bet you are, buddy.
This is first. This is to Beckett.
Oh wow!
Yeah, I got it. So, I can't
wait. Well, he's not a member of the Mega64 crew, so
yeah, you can pass this if you want.
Open that off camera.
Okay.
What do we have?
It says for Sean only.
It's a Jets fan on board.
The Bears.
Oh, yeah, this thing is for me specifically.
For Sean only.
Name this one.
Maybe.
Let's see what we got here. Not no name on the package.
I'm so glad we opened those Tim Tams.
I don't know who sent this, but let me see if there's a note.
Whoa.
There's a note. It's from Jared. It's from Jared Thorbon.
He was at Gamedays.
He was.
Mm-hmm. Jared told me he was going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Jared, you made your promise.
Jared's great.
You're good on your promise, mm-hmm. my friend.
We do.
We came to both days.
We owe you, man.
Mm-hmm.
Jared, we owe you.
I'm so excited.
Oh.
Yes! Congratulations.
But still waiting on Blu-ray DVD disc.
Combo.
Hey, he's not here right now. What if for Christmas we all get him still waiting?
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
And nothing else. If you weren't at Game Days, Rocco thought he was going to be so smart, raffled off our copy.
I kept it in the podcast.
Copy of Still Waiting on Blu-ray. But as we all know, You cannot so easily get rid of the curse waiting. Mm-mm. Thank you, Jared.
Mm-mm. Thank you, Jared.
And thank you for watching this podcast.
I still have one more box.
Oh! Sorry. Juan, you gotta have a Tim Tam and chill out, bro.
You gotta have one of these double vanilla stuffed.
Okay.
This one is also addressed to me.
Oh my god.
Dude.
Whoa!
Alright, let me try it.
Whoa!
Is this like sex with the candy guy?
It's a whole new level.
Holy crap.
The white chocolate raspberry was pretty insane.
Why are Tim Tams in the States?
The white chocolate raspberry was better. That's pretty good.
This is like a s'more.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Yep. It's better than regular Tim Tam. All the other flavors of Tim Tam are better than regular Tim Tam.
Okay. Yeah. Again. Get rid of the regular Tim Tam.
Yeah, get them. They're out.
Okay. Got that open. Drop the Tam.
Yeah,
I ate the Tam.
You Tim it up.
Rocco's his raspberry Tam.
Oh, we throw that in the trash.
Just trash it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'll probably be stale by the time he gets
this
back.
This is addressed to me from Douglas.
Mm-hmm. Doug.
All the way from Connecticut. We have...
Oh, wow.
Airbags.
Whoa!
The whole box alone.
Oh, nice.
I like when they pop.
Okay. Almost. Oh, dude, get one. Oh, I think there's more stuff in there besides the airbags.
Oh, no. Another airbag.
Oh, woo, woo. Suspenseful.
Cool.
You okay?
I'm dying.
Lean over my...
Wait, airbags save lives. All right, that helps. Thank you.
Lean. Yeah, breathe in.
Oh, here's a letter.
Better.
Okay.
You always have to open the letter first.
It's true.
It's courtesy.
Fact.
That is some nice penmanship.
Then you know who to thank.
This is like some neo-calligraphy.
How's that Surge treating you, Sean?
Is there Gruana in there?
I don't know.
It kind of tastes like what I think a Mountain Dew Slurpee
I'm ready to climb onto a thing of tires when my friend's blasting with the hose.
Yeah.
Is that what you do with
Surge? That sounds like an act.
That's a...
What kind of act?
Sexual act.
What kind of
Sorry
hose?
You had a problem with the first one.
Okay.
Whoa.
What do you have a problem with?
What? I don't know. What is
What's
it?
What's he assuming?
What's in there? Crack it open, Derek. Let's see.
Oh, man. It's a penis.
Oh.
Yeah, mine don't work.
Penis missile.
Oh. It's a box within a box.
More this is when it gets scary.
Yeah. You need that knife again?
A box within a box. A knife within a hand. Opening up this package.
Always cut towards Sean.
Always cut towards that. Sean
Never
man.
Cut towards your penis. Or
you always say that, but that's bad advice.
Why? It is bad advice. Because cut towards your penis.
Because when you're cutting towards your penis, you'll never have a more focused and safer cut made
true.
In your
you might
life.
See,
I thought it the other way. If they cut off their dick, that's one more out of the pool where, like, he's not getting a girl. You know what I mean?
I'm thinking in the wrong
Everything with you
well.
Is about getting a girl,
It
man.
Is.
There's more to life than
it's
getting
rough.
Girls. Sometimes the girls...
Are you
joking?
Really.
Sometimes the girls get you.
That can't... This isn't real.
What is it?
It's not real.
You're being trolled.
What is it?
What's wrong?
I don't know what it is.
You're being trolled.
What this is can't be real. I know what it is.
What is it?
I don't even know.
What?
That can't be real.
What?
That can't be real.
I don't understand.
Yeah, why?
Show it. Show what it is.
Why didn't we get
an
iPad
mini?
iPad mini.
Why?
Can I have it?
No.
Oh.
Derek just got an iPad mini?
Wait.
Hold on.
You said on the podcast that you're like, if somebody wants to send me an iPad.
Me.
No way.
Yeah.
No. Fucking way.
This is an extremely awkward moment.
Not fair.
What?
This Holy is not fair.
What?
Fucking you guys.
Shit. Life is not fair.
You guys.
What's the note? What's the letter?
Hold on.
I had a lot of trouble with my front row seat Super Bowl tickets last year.
No,
and like,
no.
I just think I've sworn off front row seat Super Bowl tickets.
I don't know what.
Oh, like, is it actually an iPad? Open it. I got like
my brain is like broken right
is
now.
It?
I don't even know what to do. Do I open this?
It's yours, dude.
It's a Wi-Fi 32 gigs.
It's not like you went and made an Amazon wish list, okay? You just mentioned you had an old shit iPad.
Where is the letter from this? I don't have an Amazon. It says...
He only signed it.
I know.
But there's a name here.
Douglas.
Douglas, it is Douglas.
Douglas, what is
Sorry
this?
You had a problem with the first one.
Douglas.
All right, well...
Thanks for watching the podcast and sending Derek iPad minis.
Douglas?
You can keep sending Rocco still waiting on Blu-ray.
Hey, next podcast, we should all, everyone get an iPad butt Rocco.
Hey, Douglas. Derek, what's up?
Douglas.
He was showing his appreciation for all the free media you've given
Douglas.
Him.
Yeah.
Here's what we're going to do, Douglas.
What are we going to do?
You give me three names. Any three names. Doesn't matter.
Damn.
They're done.
Douglas.
Whoa.
Doug, thanks for sending that in.
Thank you for sending that to Derek.
And thanks for watching the podcast.
Thank you.
Are these for us?
Hell yeah.
I don't know what to do with it. Like, do I unwrap this thing?
I don't know what to tell you. We'll have to talk about that.
What model is that?
It's a 32 gig. It's an iPad mini.
Check it out, man.
Yep. Everyone say goodnight.
Good night.
Thanks, Douglas.